wrong, baby, wrong, baby, to think that we could carry on the way we did, boy. No, baby, no, baby, I'm still not over you. I dream, baby, oh, baby, and every night is ending out. And S.O.S. now, baby, this is an emergency, save me. Someone's gonna tell me lonely. I just can't go on. I
That's better. Yeah, welcome to Unannounced Extra. Start a dance workout. Yo! Just doing some, like, trying to full combo things. It was good. One of the things I got was a webcam that I'm going to use for like more traditional VTubing. Okay, I'm gonna put the instant fail mode on. And see if there's the auto restart option. Auto restart on fail. Okay, good. Yeah, I just have to figure out how to convert my VR chat avatar to a VRM file for it. Damn it. Yeah. My avatar uses a bunch of weird shaders that aren't compatible with VRM files, so... Ah, fucking hell. Okay. Let's go on to a different one. Pissing me off. No text in HUD. Oh, come on. I can do that. Oh, that's how you do it. Okay. Ooh. This game is interestingly different without the UI on. Oh, I should have installed that boxing mod for today. It is Boxing Day, after all. No, seriously, there's a boxing mod. It replaces all of the notes with a dot blocks. and the sabers with boxing gloves. And instead of swiping into them, you have to punch them. I don't think it's been updated for recent versions of Beat Saber, though, so... Like, the only reason I have all of this working at all is because I downgraded Beat Saber through really complicated processes, because Valve just randomly got rid of the ability for you to downgrade for no discernible reason. So I have, like... Oh, it is... It's even worse than you're thinking. Like... I'm amazed that the chain of bullshit that I have put together right now works at all. Like, I have an entire backup of my Beat Saber folder several times over so that I can go back when Steam decides to update Beat Saber out from under me. Let me go put this down. I have any water left? I do. But I mean, VR as a whole is like annoyingly complicated, so. Oh, come on. What? Why did... What? Okay. I randomly ascended into the heavens. I don't know if that showed up on the recording or not. Did that show up? I can't. It just randomly happened. My headset view shot up like, I think, 4 meters in the sky randomly, and it made me fail the song because my arms moved too. I don't know what I did to do that. Oh, there's a clip? Oh god. Oh. DM me that clip somewhere. Because there's meme potential there. I must go. My people need me. Oh my god. You know what? Let me see if, That is amazing. laughing too hard. What does this look like? Oh, come on. Yep.
What? Why did... What? Okay.
It's amazing. It's absolutely amazing. Something that really helps with VR is to be, like, very resistant against motion sickness because, holy crap, bugs in games will give it to you. And VR games are usually, like, a friggin' billion times more complicated than normal ones, so there's, like, a billion more places for... Yeah. I think VR chat is probably, like, the super expert tier of VR suggestions. Like... It's... Like, VR chat, the game itself is optimized. It is optimized the best it can be. Every single bit of user-generated content is not. It is so not. It's always been a bit easier for me because I'm basically, like, permanently dissociated slightly. I'm pretty sure that's, like, not a good thing, but... It's convenient. It's almost like there's two sets of data, and a lot of that data surprisingly comes from your eyes. I ruined my full combo. Baby. I need to watch Love Live at some point. Probably start with like Love Live Superstar or something, since that's the most recent one. And apparently they're unrelated. Ah, three off a full combo. Darn, this one's good. This one's really good. The VR motion sickness thing really does get easier, though. It helps if you start out with games that are like very stable and have very high frame rate, like Beat Saber. Or hell, even something like Sound Self. Sound Self is probably a great gateway thing to do. Sound Self is a basically like a VR meditation environment. The only input is your voice, and you just and it's about one of the most stable FPS VR games I have, besides unmodded Beat Saber. Yeah, those stack notes like that are evil. My favorite genre of Snail House tweet, though, is when Snail House goes to Japanese arcades and plays their own songs and pretends to be a complete newbie to the game. And then just, you know, like, does super expert level gameplay. Oh yeah, it's hilarious. I mean, wouldn't you? Reminds me that Charlie Chaplin once entered a Charlie Chaplin look-alike contest. He lost and was confused. The organizers were confused when they found out that he was actually Charlie Chaplin. Still can't believe I must go. My people need me on stream. That was amazing. You know what? Do this one. No, let's not do that one. This is probably gonna get the audio for this part copy strike, but yeah, it's kind of like trashy early, a late aughts dubstep, and I don't know if I like it or not. Yeah. Fuck. Rip. I mean, it's a nice map, but the song behind it is just so garbage. So fucking garbo. Just, Oh. We must show. I got my white, you almost say, come on.
people.
Just let me know. Okay.
Stop calling me out today.
I want Taco Bell for dinner. Okay. Canadian Taco Bell breakfast Taco Bell is not the same. It is. I know, but like, or at the very least, I don't want to cook. I cooked last night. I've been good. I made this pasta. Just putting a bunch of noodles in there, a bunch of water, a bunch of salt, a bunch of pepper, some beef cubes, a Costco jar of sauce, and then setting it for 6 minutes. This is so slow. Is there a faster notes? There is not. It's faster song, but not faster notes. Three 20. This is either.
Thank you.
Okay, the lasers like this are really beautiful, but holy crap. It is making me think the horizon is moving. Is the overlay working when I have the in-game UI disabled? Okay, good. Okay, good. Oh, I missed the last note. God damn it. Gonna walk over here to get my backup glass of water since my water bottle's out. If there's anything that being an SRE has taught me, it's always have a backup. And in my case, I have backup water. Because you never know when you need your backup water. Site reliability engineer. It's basically like the people like me that, sort of just like desperately hack things into working and are very good at responding to when things are not working. Yeah, basically. I've been thinking about making doing like an online class or something once I have the VTubing rig set up for SRE fundamentals and like how to actually do it. I mean, the Google SRE book is fine, but a lot of it misses the fact that SRE was a bit of culture that came out of Google because Google's internal culture was totally non-functional. So the SRE team just basically started as a bunch of people that said, like, no, fuck you, it is going to work, or we won't help you. Really, in actuality, an SRE is sort of just like the the uber generalist. Like, ideally, you want someone who has, like, a little bit of everything. A little bit of, like, programming. A little bit of sysadmin. And, a rank S skill in Googling. Because, holy crap, you are going to need to Google a lot. With SRE stuff, it's common to, find out that there's, like, some sort of component that is... like completely broken, but you've never even heard of this thing before or any of the fundamentals for it. So you have to like get yourself up to speed, fix it, and then go on fixing everything else. The other annoying truth is that most service downtime is internal. Almost none of it is customer facing, and when it does get customer facing, that means it's really bad. This is a place where microservices can both help and bite you because the microservice model is like, you know, microservices everywhere. And that doesn't always help. Ooh. I mean, don't get me wrong, the microservice model does work sometimes. It's just... you aren't Google. I forgot to download the Leak Saber crap. Yeah, I think I'm about at my limit for the day. Sleepy. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you have a good day. And I'm glad I didn't just fly away into the stratosphere without warning again. Yeah. Stay safe. It's cold out there.